Muy buenas noches a todos. Bienvenidos a este encuentro postpartido de los Leones del Escogido. En esta victoria hoy 2-1 sobre las Águilas Cibaeñas, tenemos a nuestro dirigente Dave Jaus. Thank you very much, Mr. Jaus, for being here with us. Y vamos a escuchar las preguntas. Recuerden que tenemos el mismo formato. Solicitan los turnos en el chat y ahí pues le cedemos la palabra para que realicen las preguntas. Vamos a iniciar con Jordaniel Abreu. Adelante.
Dave, great job tonight. Ty Chidiman was the winner pitcher. This was his second win in the season. Talk us about the performance tonight, about the performance of Tillman.
The whole pitching staff did what they needed to do. I'm glad you brought out Tiedemann because he's had a really good start to the year. I know he's had success in the past, and after not being able to pitch this year, Texas and you know, wanted him to come down here. Our organization, Escogido, wanted him to come down and use his strengths, which is an ability to be aggressive, throw the fastball in all of the four quadrants, and use the slider, and compete. I believe that might be his best skill, is he competes. And there's a whole lot of big league pitchers that compete. So I take the thing tonight is I love the competitor out there on the mound, and Ty Tiedemann.
Sobre la pregunta de Jordaniel de la actuación de Ty Tiedemann esta noche, dice que fue, en general, la actuación del pitcheo fue bastante buena esta noche. En el caso de Tiedemann, resalta lo competitivo que es. Estuvo lanzando muy bien esta noche con su recta, los lanzamientos rompientes como el slider estuvo funcionando también. La bola rápida en las esquinas la estuvo colocando. Y sobre todo, que es importante porque ha venido de menos a más, no pudo lanzar en el verano y está ahora con el equipo haciendo el trabajo y está bastante contento por lo que está realizando, sobre todo por su actitud competitiva. Tenemos a Arvin González. Adelante, Arvin.
Sí, gracias, Michael. Saludos a los colegas. Hi, Mr. Jaus. I would like to know your take on the team defense, especially dealing without Barrera, and how Julio E. Rodriguez performed tonight, and also how are you shifting the infield, especially coming from a manager like you, that you were a vital part of the Pirates, ending the longest Peter's outreaching the postseason?
Really good question, because when you talk about pitching and pitching doing well, you should always talk about the catcher and defense. And Julio did a really good job. I do want us to remember that Julio's had a really good start to the year defensively. And the most important part of a catcher's job, both Barrera and Rodriguez, have done it, and that's defense. That's managing the pitching staff. It's calling the game. It's blocking balls. It's, again, being competitive, like we talked about with Ty Tiedemann. And then infield-wise, when those balls are put on the ground, they need to be outs. And all five infielders we used today made those ground balls out. Denand, Guzman, both Lopez and Castillo at second, and a couple times in the shift, and then Espinal at first. So really good question, and that's pitching and defense won the game tonight.
Sobre la pregunta de los receptores de Tres Barrera y de Julio Rodríguez, el dirigente resalta la calidad de receptores defensivos que son ambos, cómo pueden manejar el picheo, cómo pueden llevar el juego. Y parte de eso, en el caso de Julio Rodríguez, pues fue determinante en la victoria de esta noche que pudo conseguir el equipo. Julio, que estuvo recibiéndole a varios lanzadores del equipo, y eso pues ayudó la forma en que él llevó el juego, pues conseguir la victoria al final del partido. Otra pregunta de Jordaniel. Adelante, Jordaniel.
Dave, Chas McCormick came back tonight and he hit two hits and in three at bats. Talk us about the recovery of McCormick.
We probably took an extra couple days to make sure those legs were right, because that part of his game are his legs. Really good corner outfielder. He can be a good center fielder. We just have two or maybe three really good center fielders in Liberato, Mesa, and now Florian. But his legs are important, and your legs are important for defense, base running, and swinging the bat. He came right back, and some of us kind of knew it right away. The Defoe leading off the game hit that two-strike foul ball down the left field line, foul, and Chaz had a really good first step. And I looked at our staff. I said, he's okay. Sure enough, Liberato had a line drive in that inning, and Rodriguez had a line drive in that, a fly ball to get a good jump on. All three guys showed that they were healthy, because all three guys were not ready to go to start on Wednesday night. So it's nice to see our outfield coming around, and we got a whole lot more outfielders now, so we're going to have to make some moving parts to see where everybody plays.
Bien, sobre la pregunta del retorno de Chas McCormick al equipo, dice el dirigente que tuvo una lesión ligera en las piernas y que fue importante cómo se ha recuperado y cómo se vio en el partido de hoy. Las piernas son sumamente determinantes al momento de batear, al momento de correr las bases y también al momento de jugar defensa. Entonces, Chas es sumamente importante en esa parte, lo mismo que con los jugadores, los otros jardineros como Melky Mesa y los demás que mencionó. Y la idea es tener esos jugadores saludables para poder tener defensa efectiva en esa zona del terreno. Y se alegra bastante de que McCormick esté saludable ya participando con el equipo. Tenemos una pregunta de Luis Miguel Sena. Puedes hacer la pregunta en español, Luis Miguel. Te ayudamos con la traducción.
Muy buenas noches para todos los que están aquí en nuestra rueda de prensa. Para mí un placer. Una pregunta para el dirigente de los Leones del Escogido. La pregunta es la siguiente. Una buena actuación el día de hoy de Iván Castillo. ¿Qué tanto pueden mejorar los Leones para tener una buena racha, aunque sea de 3 o 4 partidos? ¿Qué crees que pueden mejorar los Leones en los próximos días, como es una temporada corta, una temporada recortada? ¿Qué crees que pueden mejorar para poder obtener una buena racha?
What do you think we can improve as team to get a streak of win in this short season?
It's a good question for you guys, and I'm going to answer it the same way I do all the time. I apologize that I was late. We had to do some things with celebrating a win. The players have a lot of fun. They celebrate. We have to do some roster moves at the end. And because of protocol, we did it out in the club, out in the dugout, and all sorts of stuff. So I apologize for being late. I'm also going to say I'm sorry again that today we are 1-0. Tomorrow we're shooting to be 1-0. If for some reason it was a doubleheader, tomorrow we'd be shooting for 2-0. But outside of that, I'm not going to talk about a streak. Now, I am going to tell you that your question is really good, because when you play good baseball, you execute, you pitch, you play defense, you base run, and you compete and play together, then you win some games. But we only talk about winning tomorrow, and today's done, but we were 1-0. We're going to go and go 1-0 tomorrow.
Dice que no le gusta hablar de rachas, le gusta hablar del partido del día. En el caso de hoy, pues se consiguió la victoria. No sabe qué va a pasar mañana. Si se gana mañana, serán 2-0. Pero la idea es ejecutar los fundamentos, ejecutar defensa, picheo, bateo, para tratar de conseguir la victoria. Y eso es lo que el equipo está tratando de hacer. Pero que no le gusta hablar del futuro, sino de lo que se ha conseguido. Y esta noche se consiguió una victoria y siempre se trabaja para conseguir una victoria. Es lo que haremos mañana y en los partidos subsiguientes. Tenemos una pregunta de Melvin Bejarán. Adelante.
Hi, Dave. Iván Castillo left the game earlier. What's happened with him? What's his situation? ¿Cuál es la situación de Iván Castillo que abandonó el juego temprano?
Well, actually left the game because I thought it was a better matchup. Mesa hit. He was not removed for any factor other than in that situation with a runner on second and the lefty coming in. As good a hitter as Iván Castillo is right-handed, Mesa in that situation I thought had a better chance to drive in the run. Now I hit the ball too hard because it was a one-hop ball to left fielder, and Julio is a really good catcher. Had another good at-bat today. He's had a couple good ones, drove the ball. But he'll even admit that he's not the fastest guy. And Filipito wanted to try to send him and couldn't, and made the right decision to hold him. So Iván did not come out because of any sort of injury factor. Now I tell you this though, is that he has had some situations early in the year and he's come back really well physically. His arm's getting back. And we're not sure that maybe he did something in the game. And we will let you know tomorrow because he's in and taking care of some things. But that's not the reason he's removed. And he's really playing well defensively at second base and swinging the bat, being really good at the top of the order. We're ready for Lopez to play. We're ready for Rosa to play. Whoever's ready to play tomorrow, they'll be in there.
Dice que Iván tuvo una ligera lesión en la parte inferior del cuerpo, pero que espera que no sea nada grave. De hecho, al principio de la temporada también estuvo algo lesionado, pero pudo recuperarse y es lo que espera que pueda hacer para mañana, si es posible. Pero si no es posible, pues tienen a Otto López y tienen otras opciones en la segunda base para cubrir a Iván. Y resalta también las cualidades defensivas y cómo ha estado haciendo el swing Iván Castillo para poder producir para el equipo y, como el caso de hoy, pues ayudar con la victoria. Tenemos una pregunta de Jordaniel. Jordaniel, adelante.
Dave, Franchi Cordero would be debuting tomorrow. What would be the use that Dave Jones would give him in his first games?
I'll tell you, I haven't made tomorrow's lineup out. If you know something, help me out, because until I'm told by Jose Gomez in the front office, I won't talk about tomorrow's guys and I won't talk about someone that's not on the roster. I have seen him. I've seen him in the hotel. I've gotten reports about him at the alternate camp, and he's some kind of player, some kind of athlete, ready to be with us when he's ready. But I think when I write his name in the lineup, then I'll talk about him, and he wasn't in the lineup today. So I hate I can't pass on anything, and maybe you passed on something to me, and I'll learn about it tomorrow. So thank you.
Dice que lo que puedo hablar es de lo que ha pasado hoy, que para mañana pues no sabe si él va a estar, si no va a estar. Lo ha visto jugando, lo ha visto en el hotel, le ha tenido reportes sobre Franchi Cordero, que fue la pregunta que hizo Jordaniel sobre su debut, pero que hay que esperar cuando él esté listo, cuando esté en el lineup, que no fue la situación de hoy, para poder evaluar su desempeño y saber entonces cómo lo estaría utilizando en el equipo, pero que mientras tanto está fuera del lineup y prefiere hablar de lo que ha sucedido en el día. Concluimos con Arvin González.
Gracias, Michael. Dave, finally, you have really some good depth in the outfield. You have like 7 guys that could be regular in another team. And I would like to know how you're going to deal with that, building the lineup, and also, as you work in the same organization that Esteban Floreal, I would like to hear some insights about him.
That's a really good question. I love that question because, yes, in the States, I work with the New York Yankees. I actually wrote up a report on Esteban this year and his first major league hit and his first game in the doubleheader. It was really fun to watch. And I have some more interest in the States about a young man like that being with the Yankees. However, there's no difference between Florian or Frenchy Cordero or Pueyo or Mesa or Polanco or Liberato or Chas McCormick. All those outfielders, Rodriguez, all those outfielders, while they're here with Escogido, they're going to get all of our impact from all the input from us, myself, the coaching staff, and we're going to get them better for this year in Escogido and for what club they go. Now, the question about playing time, it's a nice situation to have when you have really good players and you have to find out how to maneuver them around to get their at-bats and best use them. When I figure that out, I think you'll see that it happening, and so will the players. And I'm putting the pieces together with on how we're going to do it using the analytics department, the front office, the major league clubs, the clubs that have those guys, our outfield coach, Filipito, our batting coach, Mejia, bench coach, Ramon, quality control coach, Blake Butera, and holy cow, Gilbert Gomez, working with some of those guys like Franchi and Alvarez down at 7 o'clock in the morning at the alternate camp right before Alvarez the other day hit a bullet his first time up when he was first put on our roster. So it's a long way to answer that it's a nice problem to have, and you'll see it happening, and the players will know it before you do.
Bueno, le pregunta Arvin sobre varios jugadores que pueden ser regulares en el equipo, pero que no lo son. Mencionaron varios nombres, en el caso de César Pueyo, de Melky Mesa, de Chas McCormick, y dice que es una especie de agradable dolor de cabeza tener esos jugadores juntos, pero está probando, está intentando colocar cada uno esas piezas de rompecabezas, colocarlas durante el partido. Algunos están juntos en algún momento, otros no, pero hay que darles tiempo de juego a cada uno de ellos para ver cómo evolucionan y cómo puede trabajarse en la alineación día a día. Es bueno tener jugadores como esos, jugadores de calidad, pero siempre toma en cuenta los reportes también de los coaches que ya mencionó ahí, que escucharon cuáles eran los nombres, y en base a eso pues se estructura el equipo de día a día, pero que son jugadores que son muy buenos, todos esos que mencionaron, y es muy difícil ponerlos a todos jugar juntos, porque juegan básicamente las mismas posiciones, pero son jugadores muy talentosos, y lo importante es darle a cada uno el tiempo de juego suficiente para ver cómo desarrollan sus habilidades y cómo contribuyen con el equipo. Señores, muchas gracias. Thank you very much, Mr. Jaus. Pasen buenas noches y será hasta un próximo encuentro.